Deus qui inter sumus sacerdotes famum tuum benedictum, ineffabile tua dispositionis connumerare voluisti, praesta quaesus, ut qui unigeniti fini tui vices interis geribant, sanctorum tuorum pontificum consortium, perpetua aggregatum, per unum Domum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium Tuum, qui tecum vivere regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Thank you. our readings for this Requiem Mass. The epistle comes from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, I tell you a mystery. We shall all indeed rise, but we shall not all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall rise incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible body must put on incorruption, and this mortal body must put on immortality. But when this mortal body puts on immortality, then shall come to pass the word that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy victory? O death, where is thy sting? Now the sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God who has given us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. And please stand for a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. At that time, Jesus said to the multitudes of the Jews, Amen, amen, I say to you, the hour is coming and now is here, when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear shall live. For as the Father has life in himself, even so he has given to the Son also to have life in himself. And he has granted him power to render judgment, because he is Son of Man. Do not wonder at this, for the hour is coming in which all who are in the tombs shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they who have done good shall come forth unto the resurrection of life, but they who have done evil unto the resurrection of judgment. And thus far the words of the Holy Gospel. We find ourselves gathered here to mourn and grieve and pray for a beloved Pope, Pope Benedict XVI. In our mourning and our prayers, we are moved and comforted by the beautiful music of Mozart, music that was so dear to Pope Benedict. He told us that whenever we hear Mozart in church, there is more truth than many, many sermons. So what can be added to all that has been said or will be said at this time of mourning, at this time of burial of our beloved Pope Benedict? What can be added to so many words that will be given? Today I want to use his own words and our reflection as we continue this Holy Mass in honor of and for Pope Benedict. First of all, there is what stands before us, the stark contrast, the black, the Requiem candles, the vestments, amidst the Christmas decorations and ornaments. And yet it brings to mind a very touching story, a true story, of a handwritten note, a beautiful handwritten note written by Joseph Ratzinger in 1934. He was 7 years old, and it was just before Christmas. In beautiful handwriting, Joseph Ratzinger, 7 year old, wrote this note. Dear baby Jesus, please quickly come down to earth. You will bring joy to children. Also bring me joy. I would like a Mass prayers book, green clothing for Mass, and a heart of Jesus. I will always be good. Greetings from Joseph Ratzinger. Well, we loved him. And he loved us, and he knew that. He knew exactly what it was to be a pope as a father to his people, not leaving us orphans. He knew what it was to receive and experience the embrace of his flock, of his children. It was in 2013, he said, many people who love the Lord also love the successor of St. Peter and feel great affection for him. The Pope truly has brothers and sisters, sons and daughters throughout the world. He feels secure in the embrace of your communion because he no longer belongs to himself. He belongs to all, and all belong to him. He understood the affection of a father to the children. He understood your affection. What an incredible legacy, a unique and total unparalleled service to the Church. As a priest, as a bishop, as an archbishop, when he assumed the patron office as our chief shepherd, the office of the Vicar of Christ, if you remember that day when he came out on the balcony, the words that he first spoke, "I am consoled that the Lord knows how to work with insufficient instruments. I am consoled the Lord knows how to work with insufficient instruments." But that was not the pinnacle of his ministry, of course. His life as our chief shepherd, his holding the office, his great legacy, his last service was the most important. And he tells us this in his own words. Prayer. When Pope Benedict resigned from the office of Peter in 2013, he told us clearly he was not abandoning us. He would be with us more fully as he prayed for our church. Hear his words, the words of his last audience. "I am not abandoning you or the cross, but remaining in a new way at the side of the crucified Lord." It was at this audience that he took the opportunity, the last time he publicly spoke as a successor of St. Peter to us, he took the opportunity to speak about hope. My dear friends, let these words truly resonate. He says, "At times, I felt like St. Peter with the apostles in the boat on the Sea of Galilee. The Lord has given us so many days with sun and light winds. There were also moments when the waters were rough and the winds were against us, as throughout the church's history, and the Lord seemed to be sleeping. But I have always known that the Lord is in the boat, and I have always known that the bark of the church is not mine, but it's his." He continues, "The Lord doesn't let the church sink. It is he who guides it, surely also those through whom he have chosen, because he wished that. This has been and is a certainty which nothing can shake." To close that audience, he wrote, "Dear friends, God guides his church. He sustains it. It's always, especially at times of difficulty. Let us never lose this vision of faith. In the heart, in our hearts, in the heart of each one of you, may there always be the joyful certainty that the Lord is at our side. He does not abandon us. He remains close to us, and he surrounds us with his love." Yes, his great legacy, after every post and office he held, even after that moment when he wished for retirement as a cardinal and said yes to the office of St. Peter, but his greatest work was the work, and he knew it was his greatest, was the work of prayer for the church. For a decade, this last decade, in the Vatican Gardens, there he prayed and was united with us, united with his church. But still, he prays for us, and even more now, the veil is very thin between heaven and earth. When somebody has passed on with a like life like that, a holy death, his last words, "I love you, Jesus. Jesus, I love you." But the veil is thin between us and him. Those who have died are closer than before, especially at this and every Holy Mass. A bit of a personal story, which offers some reflection. With some of the members of the Canons Regular, I was able to be present for a special mass at St. Patrick Cathedral in 2007. This was in New York City. And what an incredible liturgy it was, I never forgot, when the Pope intoned the Gloria and sat down as we listened to Palestrina's Missa Papa Marcelli. To the beauty of the liturgy, you felt right at home. But what was so moving was a striking analogy he gave in a sermon. He used stained glass windows. He told the people present in the cathedral that day in April, "Look at the windows. From the outside, those windows are dark, heavy, even dreary. But once one comes inside the church, they suddenly come alive. The windows reflect the light passing through them. They reveal their splendor. It is only from the inside, from the experience of faith, that we see the church as she truly is, flooded with grace, resplendent in beauty, adorned by the manifold gifts." He then tells us about what happens when that light is dimmed. Even those of us within the church, the light of faith can be dimmed by routine. The splendor of the church can be obscured by the sins and weaknesses of her members, scandal. The light, too, can often be dimmed by the obstacles encountered in a society which seems to have forgotten God and to resent even the most elementary demands of Christian morality. But, he says, the Word of God reminds us that in faith we see the heavens open and the grace of the Spirit lighting up, bringing sure hope to the world. It was at that beautiful Mass in St. Patrick's Cathedral, after he gave that sermon, that I was able to give him a card with the crest of the Canons Regular written inside, "Thank you for the motu proprio, thank you for restoring the sacred." It was a beautiful moment to see a very gentle soul. But what did he show us? He showed us there is never a reason for a Catholic to be without hope. There's never a reason for a Catholic to be without hope, because a Catholic has faith. When you come inside the church, you see the light through those windows. Same things in our own souls. At this time, to close, I would like to read from the final paragraph of Pope Benedict's spiritual testament. This is his final message to us. And out of respect for him, I would like us to all stand as I read this paragraph. My dear friends, I now say to all those in the church, stand firm in the faith. Do not let yourselves be confused. It often seems that science, the natural sciences on one hand, and historical research are able to offer irrefutable results at odds with the Catholic faith. But it is now 60 years that I have been accompanying the journey of theology. And with the succession of different generations, I have seen theses that seemed unshakable collapse, proving to be mere hypotheses. The liberal generation, the existentialist generation, the Marxist generation. But I saw and I see how out of the tangle of assumptions, the reasonableness of the faith emerged and has emerged and emerges again. Jesus Christ is truly the way, the truth, and the life. And the church, even with its insufficiencies, is truly his body. Finally, I humbly ask, pray for me, so that the Lord, despite all my sins and my insufficiencies, that he welcomes me into the eternal dwellings. To all those entrusted to me day by day, my heartfelt prayer goes out. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May his soul and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Thank you. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Sursum corda.
Adeus ad Dominum.
Gratias agamus Domino Deo nostro. Justum esse cum et salutare, nos tibi semper et ubique gratias agere. Domine Sancte Pater omnipotens aeterne Deus, per Christum Dominum nostrum. In quo nobis spes beata resurrectionis effusit, ut quos contrista certo moriendo conditio, eustem consoletur futuritat futuri immortalitatis promissio. Tui senem fidelibus domini vita mutatur non tolitur, et dissoluta terrestris uius incolados domo, et tena in celis habitatio comparatur. Et ideo cum angelis et arcangelis, cum thronis et dominationibus, cumque omni militia celestis exercitus, imnum gloriae tue canimus, sine fine dicentes.
benedixit, de decrucibus obedicens, ac cipite epibre exe omnes. Hic est enem calix sanguinis mei, novi retina testamentum est reimpire, qui pro vobis et imotes fundedum, in remission peccatorum.
Thank you.
seculorum.
Amen.
Oremus preceptis salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere. Pater noster qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicur in cielo et in terra, panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicur et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Thank you.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et spiritu tuo.
Oremus. Prosit quaesimus Domine, anime famili tui benedicti, sum pontificis, misericordiae tui implorate clemencia, ut eos in quo speravit et credidit, aeternum capiat te miserantia consortium, per Domum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te convivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Requiescat in pace.